Morning, guys. It is 7 o'clock in the morning. Wonderful sunny day. Excellent. Today we're gonna climb Khunjerab pass, and we slept in this hotel where only we. Now I can see a guy from Austria, another one Spanish guy. So many bikes here. So this two KLRs, one Suzuki V-Storm and one Honda Varadero. The room was good. Cost us only less than $20, but it's big enough. And what surprised us that we've got internet, which was excellent. It doesn't work now, but it was worked last night, which was some kind of surprise. Pack the stuff and go.
Another day, another adventure. So, as I told you, it was only us. Now I can see two KLRs or three KLRs from Quebec, Canada. This guy with V-Storm is from Austria, and Honda Transalp from Spain. I don't know where they came from, because I did not hear anything last night. Maybe they came from China, maybe they are on the way to China. I don't know. Anyway, it's another nice, beautiful morning with sunshine, and we're on the way to Khunjerab pass. I'm ready from 30 minutes, waiting for my friend to pack and prepare the bike. He's already done, and we'll go. Okay, we'll refill the tanks and go. Look at this, guys, it's so beautiful. The petrol, guys, is around 80 cents. Very cheap. You ready? Inshallah. Okay, finally we're ready. So the road starts in this interesting, like a canyon, like this between the rocks. Nice. Very, very beautiful landscapes here. Another one group of riders with 150cc. On the shadows is very cold, on the sun is fine, but more we go up, colder it will be. I need to stop to change my gloves and to put my windstopper. There will be some sections like this, I hope not for that long. Thank you. just stopped to register ourselves, pay about the entry fee. It was 800 rupees for both of us, which is something like $6. Fine. So another one stop to for registration. They scanned my passport and also they made me a picture. So it's all from a safety reasons. If you get lost, they will know that you've been on this checkpoint and they will look for you between this checkpoint and the next one. So it's nothing to worry about. Great, isn't it? Man, the view is getting better and better and better. I have to keep eating this stuff, these things, this dried food. I don't know exactly what it is. It's like a peach, but smaller. I know what it is, but I don't know English word anywhere. You have to have this all the time to prevent problems with altitude. I think we are on 3,500 meters here, something like that. But we have to go to 4,800. There is a large population of leopards here, and you can see the signs everywhere. So maybe I'll be lucky to see one. So they even inform us that they might come to the road, so just to be careful. Look at now this yak. We start the serious climbing now. You can see the snow peaks over there. Man, nice. Definitely lack of power already. You can hear the noise of the engine. Sounds like I need more. All right. Just quick shot. Show what it is. Nice, huh?
Made it!
Not yet.
15 kilometer more.
That's alright. Just want to make one picture here. Yeah, it's beautiful. So, 15 kilometers more. From here, I started a serious climbing. And my friend Enif did not stop because he has underpowered engine now, and he prefers just to keep doing. Anyway. I'll catch him somewhere on the top. Okay, here you go. Man, it's beautiful here, beautiful. Look at this. Ay, ay, ay. All good? Second, third gear. Fourth? No, go back to third. It's wild, wild here, wild. Look at this peak. I better look on the road. So here is some dirt section. It's all right. Just for a while. We have more about 10 kilometers, but I just want to show you this. Look at this. Amazing, amazing. Let's do it, guys. Let's do it. See? You can hear. No power. No power. Nice. Look at the peak over there. Look at this. It's amazing. Okay, I just want to wait for him because, for example, if he stopped, I wouldn't be able to see it. Anyway, I'm gonna catch him now. I'm almost there, almost there. Maybe 5 kilometers more. I'm just about maybe 500 meters from Khunjerab Pass. This is the world highest border, and we spent the last 1 hour riding in these amazing scenarios. Look at these guys. It's like one different world. The air is very thick here. Even the bike now is struggling, even that it's a injection system, but anyway, we made it. So this is the parking spot. I don't know, are we able to go there up to the end where exactly the Chinese symbol is? We're gonna see now. I'm gonna wait for my friend Enif to come, and then we'll see what is the way here. So all around us are these huge mountains, and here the elevation is 4,880. And hey, how are you? Look at now, guys. Look at all this. Where is what?
Your colleague.
Now he's coming. He's coming, yeah. Look at this. The world's highest border. Let me turn on my cell phone to see the elevation. Come on. Good. Can we go there? Enif, can we go there? Freezing. Can we go there or not?
Yes.
Okay. Let's go there, huh? Yeah. Let's go there and then we'll stop and talk. Okay, we'll try to get up to the end. Okay, we'll walk there anyway. My friend, any freezing. not good, huh? Let's walk a bit and we will get warm. So actually we need to stop the bikes here. See around us. Nice.
My friend, world's highest ATM.
Okay. So this is the world's highest ATM in Pakistan. Look at this. Nice. Kashgar 420 kilometers. Okay. Just to show you the world's highest border. Khunjerab Pass. We did it. We just came from Sust. Over there, about 100 kilometers away, and this is the places we wanted to visit. This is actually the last point on my trip to Pakistan. From here, I will go only back. Have a look now around us. It's just amazing. The elevation here is, I'll show you exactly what it is now. I have it on my telephone. Let me see it. So it is. Let me check it now. Just checking the elevation. You're good? We did it, my friend. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. With your help, just was priceless. Just try to check the elevation now. Okay, you can see it, guys, or maybe you cannot, but it is 4,680 meters exactly. And we just passed the 4,680. We just passed over there the world highest ATM machine. And I want to say a big thank you to many people. First, I want to say thank you to my family. They always support me in all of my trips. They are just great. I just love you. After that, I want to help to my friend Enif. Great help. I want to say thank you to my sorry, I make a mistake maybe because of the TK. I want to say thank you to all Pakistani guys, everybody who made me and support me on the road. Was just great. And after that, of course, big thank you to my supporters, Smart Turn Systems from Slovenia. They partly support my trip. Great guys, I highly recommend them. I have a banner in my website if you want to go and check them out. Thank you to all of my supporters from my YouTube channel. Everybody who donate money for me, you are just great. Because of you, I am able to come and see all of this. And thanks to all of my patrons and everybody who is watching my videos. It was just amazing trip. And what else? I want to say to thank you to everyone who I met on the road and everyone who I'm gonna meet on the road. It was just one of my dreaming points, and I'm here in Khunjerab Pass. It's all right. Canadian guys, what is your name? Tell me, what's your name?
Yeah,
Tahir. Tahir.
I'm from Canada.
Canada.
Yeah.
Hello, how are you? What's your name?
Mayan, from France.
From France? And you, this is your local guide, yeah?
Yeah.
All right. I'll have you on video. Hi, how are you? What's your name?
Hello, guys. Rhys from France.
From France?
And you?
I'm from Bulgaria. My name is Pavlin from Bulgaria. Hi.
From Canada.
From Canada again. Nice to see you. Dobar den. Yes, exactly. Dobar den. Just a few more meters, huh?
Yeah.
Was great, yeah.
Out of breath. It's too high.
Well, it's all right. You'll be all right after a while.
So how was your trip?
Excellent, excellent.
Where you started?
Karachi.
Oh, nice.
From Karachi.
All the way here,
huh? All the way to here, yeah.
Nice.
But from here now we'll go down to Islamabad and I will fly to Mumbai, India. And we'll take another bike, go around India and Nepal. I'll finish in Calcutta, India, and then fly to Bangladesh, take another bike, and go around Bangladesh.
Which motorbike will you get in
Royal Enfield Himalaya. Royal Enfield Himalaya. It's like off-road bike.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, it is. Yes, yes, they have. It's like dual sport bike. It's a good bike for this type of trips. Okay, guys, all the best for you. Good luck on your trip. Be careful on the way down, especially if you have a drum brakes. Be careful.
Yeah.
All right. Thank you. Thank you.
Did you rent the bike in
No, this is his bike. He lent me this bike.
But at Bangladesh, did you rent the bike?
No, I'm not going to rent. They will give it for me for free. Friends.
Ah, friends, okay.
But you can rent the bikes. There are a lot of bikes there. You can rent. To do something very special, to use the world's highest toilet to make pee-pee, all right? So we have to walk back from the border up to the parking because they not let us to go with the bikes. The bikes are there. Yeah, beautiful, beautiful scenarios everywhere. Ah, nice, nice here. Nice, huh? Just to show you this, guys, if you have an idea to come here and play your drone, it's forbidden. You have to ask for special permission, and I'm not sure that they're gonna give it to you. Alright. Alright, time to go back.